mister.
You this bored, you want to make an enemy?
You out to trouble me.
I've had better days, that's for sure.
Oh!
Well, looky here. Maybe this is our man.
You a bounty hunter, mister?
Maybe. It depends.
Well, I'm guessing you ain't here to pass the day, turn yourself in, or discuss the finer points of county law. Then I don't need to know much more than that till I got a reason to.
All right.
You smell that? This here's a livestock town, mister. Attracts delinquents and reprobates like flies. Now, I'm not a feller to pass a quick judgment, but I've been around long enough to know you don't hire a saint to catch a sinner. You bring me what I need, and I'll pay you well, and I won't ask no questions.
So, what is it you need?
Why don't you have a look at that poster on the wall over there?
He's a low-down huckster. He's been poisoning folks with his miracle cure from here to Annsburg. Killed more than Landon Ricketts without even pulling a trigger. Gets some kind of sick satisfaction out of it.
Feller over at the saloon says he thought he saw him by the gorge straight north of here. You think you can bring him in? The money's good. I need him alive, though. I want to make sure the women he witted get compensated before he swings.
I'll see what I can do.
Well, good luck to you.
And we need him alive. That's an important point.
Alive, I got it.
Mister.
Howdy.
Mister.
Hey, mister.
Hey, partner. Mister? Here. Are you Benedict Albright?
Oh, sir?
Huh. Kind of look like him. And I was told he'd be up here.
No.
Not me, sir.
It's because I want to buy some medicine. And I heard good things. I'll pay in gold. If you could help me find him. It's just, my mother's real sick.
Oh, well, if that's the case, if it's for a sick woman, I'd be happy to help. I'm a healer, you know, a medical man. Finest medicine in the state.
Game's over, mister. Put your hands up. I'm taking you in.
Taking me in? What for?
Apparently that stuff you're pushing is killing folk. And there's a price on your head. I don't know. It ain't my business.
Come on, partner. That's crap. I'm a healer. I got an aura. I speak to spirits. I'm a scientist. Folks get real angry for no good reason. This is a mistake.
Keep your hands up, buddy. They only want you for questioning.
I have to insist that this is a mistake.
Don't be a fool.
Hold on.
I'm slipping. Shit.
Sorry.
Swim to the edge, or grab on to something. Keep your head above
the
water. Look out, the rapids. Hold your breath. Don't you dare drown.
Must be suffering from exposure. Oh, I seem to keep blacking out. Oh.
Yeah, you do seem to keep blacking out.
This isn't necessary. I'm a medical man, a healer. It's all just a big mistake. Oh, I don't feel very well.
I told you to shut up.
Who made you judge?
I'm only in it for the money.
Oh, I don't feel well at all. You're a bully, sir.
Oh, boy, I don't need to get involved with this.
He don't understand you more, and that's... Oh, my lord. I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Mrs. Calthorpe was just leaving.
Sure. Where you want him?
I'm selling the back. Some terrible mistake. I never did it. Any of it.
I thought I told you to shut up, partner.
But I told
you. But nothing. Shut up. And good luck. It's been real fun.
You ain't much of a man. You ask folks for forgiveness, you remember this, partner.
I've already forgotten. Now, sure, how much was you offering?
$50. Here.
Thank you. Madam.
Please, remember what I told you.
Ah. Scores Daddy Rhodes Bloodfeud. Break weight man or burn to the ground. Move it.
Arthur. Arthur, get over here.
What do you want?
Oh, don't be like that.
This is a good one.
Yeah, it always is with you. Until we start getting shot at.
Well, have you ever been shot at by a cow?
Whose cows?
It's Drunken Rancher up at Hill Haven Ranch. He's such a flop that we could take a whole marching band up there and steal, and he still wouldn't wake up. And he's a son of a bitch. He said unkind things about me.
No, you ain't all bad then.
I owe you after last time. This could be my make good.
I don't know.
I need you. You know those two bastards that buy stolen livestock.
Sure, I know them, but I don't like them.
I'll give you 60% of the take.
How many cows?
I don't know, small herd, I guess. 20, maybe?
20, huh? Come on.
Okay, let's mount up.
So where's this ranch?
It's right in the middle of Scarlet Meadows, just past the road's turnoff.
So how'd you find out about this place?
I've been hanging around the saloon in Rhodes a bit.
Rhodes?
Yeah, the barkeep there gossips like a fishwife. And a couple of times he's mentioned how this rancher's a fall-down drunk these days. Sounds like he don't know his ass from his armpit half the time.
You sure you ought to be hanging around Rhodes after everything that happened?
What do you mean?
I mean, it ain't gonna do your health no good if they find out you ride with us.
Nah, it's fine. I was never there at the same time as you boys. And they'd never reckon on a distinguished old feller like me running with a bunch of reprobates.
Well, just be careful. Yep. How old are you, anyway?
Well, let's just say I was born sometime between the fall of 49 and the fall of Rome. And my second wife always used to describe me as ageless, though she did leave me for a younger man.
Well, maybe we should cut you open and count the rings of whiskey.
Now, I'm ready for my retirement, though. Let me tell you.
You've been pretty much retired from the moment I met you.
Now, I mean the tropics, you know, the real deal. What Dutch is talking about. That's why I jumped on this opportunity. Sooner we get enough money to leave, the better. Dancing girls with flowers in their hair, warm sand, cold beer.
We're gonna cut up this way.
That's how I'm gonna see out my days.
Well, I'll believe it when I see it.
All right, let's get up there on foot from here. Don't want the horses clopping around outside the window. Come, let's take a closer look. Look over there.
The hell? Who are these clowns?
I don't know. This is the first time I ever seen anyone else here. Let's sneak up closer.
What? Where the hell are you going?
I think I got a plan.
Hurry up.
I'm doing the best I can, so shut up.
Hurry up and be quiet.
Ow. You said he was a drunkard. You said that we...
Shit, you hear that? Get your gun out.
Come on, you better break the padlock. My lockpicking skills ain't what they used to be.
What a surprise.
That was loud.
Yeah, well, we ain't got time. You said he ain't gonna wake up, and we ain't seen him yet. I'll get him out, right up next to the house to keep him from running off on us. Keep moving!
Well, hey there. What you got?
Cattle.
Well, I can see that. Whose cattle?
Yours now, if the price is right.
Well, I can give you $50.
Okay. $50 each times 20 cattle.
No, 50 total. This is old Squeers' cattle. He knows me. I can't do better than that. I'll have to move them right away.
We'll take 200, friend.
But I got costs.
Mm.
150.
75 and not a dollar more.
100 and I don't shoot you.
So menacing. Clyde, pay your friend here. Bye now. Be careful out there. This is nasty country.
Hey, don't forget to put some in the pot.
Oh, of course. Like I told you, easy.
Sure, I guess.
I'm headed home. You coming?
Nah, I'll see you later.
Thanks for the help with this, Arthur.
Come here, Arthur.
What do you want?
Always full of sunshine, ain't you? Old Misery Guts Morgan.
What you want, Micah?
Well, I want a friend, Arthur. I want hope. I want tomorrow to mean more than today. I want this whole damn shit show to have some kind of meaning I haven't understood. But I ain't holding my breath.
Yeah, I wouldn't.
So, instead of that, how about you and me go and redistribute some property?
Redistribute?
Yep. From the Bowles Overland Stagecoach Company into our pockets.
And you'll fight this time?
I always fight.
No, you always talk. But with coaches, guns are more significant than words.
Oh, I'm fine with both, friend.
Yeah. Come on, then.
You think we need an extra gun?
Probably a good idea.
Bill, come on.
What are we doing?
Coach, stick up.
Well, excellent. I'm in.
Micah and Bill, this is a death sentence.
There's a good spot where we can hit it as it comes over the river into the swamps north of here.
You got an actual plan this time?
I got 3 sticks of dynamite. I got 2 pistols. I got you and Bill. That count as a plan?
Not really. Well, let's go. So?
I'm joking.
Who told you about this? Please tell me it wasn't an O'Driscoll this time.
Nope. A man on the inside at Bowles Overland. You can keep your funny little station friend in Rhodes. I go right to the source.
Why did he tip you off?
Charm, Bill. Not something you can learn, I regret to inform you.
Very true. You're proof of that.
Amusing. Charm. And a little money.
Right.
Which I recovered the next day when he met with a tragic boating accident. See, I don't like leaving trails, unlike the rest of you.
What do you mean by that?
We keep leading trouble right to us. We're carrying too much dead weight. We need to be leaner so we can move faster, quieter. I prefer a tight crew, just 5 or 6 strong gunmen.
Well, nobody's stopping you. There's a whole world out there. Go find the strong men you want and lead.
Hey, I like you boys. And with the price on our heads, we are wedded in this chaos, for better or for worse at this point. It would be a coward's move to bail on Dutch now. Not like John did. Heard about him disappearing on you fellers. For a year, wasn't it?
Something like that.
I don't trust him. I've been talking to Dutch. Feels to me like he's turned, challenging every move Dutch makes. I know you have your doubts about him, too, Morgan.
I got no doubts about John. I've known him for 15 years.
Well, if we really are gonna escape somewhere like me and Dutch have been talking about, let's cut across here. It'll be quicker. We're gonna need to cut some loose. From what Dutch says, the coffers are looking pretty good again. We could almost leave now if we chopped half the dead wood.
We ain't doing that.
I mean, why the hell do we need a gaggle of girls who won't even fuck you if you put a gun to their head?
I'm sure you've tried. Is it too much to ask, considering they get a piece of every damn dollar I bring in?
Everyone does their share. I don't see you lifting a finger around camp.
Swanson does his share. Molly, come on.
That's different.
See, this is what I mean. I've always liked Abigail, though. That's my kind of girl. Sully, but strong.
Well, I don't get the sense the feeling is mutual.
Okay, here we are. I'll get the explosives planted. Coach should be coming through any minute now. Them in the road over here so we can blow it as it comes over the bridge. Got some good cover over here. You hide behind this tree to my left, Morgan. Williamson, you take the other side. Try to stay out of sight. We don't want to spook them. Here they come. You gonna shoot the charges, Morgan? About time you did something. We get, cowpoke.
Enough.
Here. Thank you kindly.
Thank you.
Maybe I had you wrong, Arthur. Maybe you can win as well as fight. Or maybe you is lucky.
We'll see, I guess, how lucky any of us is.
Exactly. All right. Better get out of here. Split up, I reckon.
I knew you'd say that.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
I don't believe you.
It's just a little robbery, all right? Nothing serious.
Good. What are you robbing?
A stage. There's a stage coming through. According to the fella I met, it'll have a bunch of money aboard and no security whatsoever as it comes up the river trail between here and Catfish Jackson.
Okay. That sounds worth investigating. You and, who?
I don't know. I thought I'd do it on my own. It'll be unprotected. Won't be a huge take, but I should make out okay.
There ain't no such thing as unprotected. Now, who you want to go with?
I guess you.
Now?
I don't need no hand-holding offer.
Oh, come on, kid. But if we decide to do it once we've had a look, I'm taking half the money.
All right, let's get going then. It should be on its way right now. It seems like only yesterday you and me was shooting our way in here to rob those fools.
Yeah, I know.
I'll be glad to leave this place behind, if I'm honest. Got a bad feel to it.
At least it's got a roof.
You've got a roof. Of course, I'm outside with the juniors.
Oh, you ain't even 20 years old. Your time will come.
Follow me. I saw a good spot for an ambush.
So who's the feller told you about this?
It's a sound lead, I told you.
And what did he have to gain by giving you this information?
You mean, did I give him money or a gun? You're just gonna have to trust me on this one, Arthur.
Okay, okay, I do. You've more improved yourself the past 6 months.
Don't forget, I was on the run for murder before falling in with you boys. For 3 years. It ain't like I'm new to any of this.
Those fellas who killed your pa?
Yep. And I'd do it again right now.
Of course.
Okay, here we are. Let's leave the horses off the road to the right here.
Yeah, seems good.
The stage should be coming up the river from Catfish Jackson anytime now. There it is.
And I don't see no escorts neither. This should be a cakewalk.
Are you sure about that?
You see any? As soon as they're close enough, we'll jump out, hit them fast.
Just wait for my lead, okay? I said wait for my lead.
This is a robbery. Drop your weapons and put your hands in the air. I said drop the weapon.
Okay, okay. Just take it easy. All right, boy.
Anyone else? Anyone inside there? Answer me! Last chance. Come out, or we're coming in. Shit!
U.S. Marshals, you're under arrest.
Are you?
Evidently.
That was not the way I was expecting things to go.
You took us into a trap.
Look, I'm telling you, it was good information.
Wait.
Look, there's some money here. Not much.
Yeah, it ain't much, because it was a trap. Stage companies do this all the time. They set up traps to catch fools.
Shit.
Like you and me.
I feel like a fool.
Well, that's good, because you are a fool. You're still alive, so don't worry too much about it. Come on, get out of here before any more turn up.
All right. See you back at camp.
Arthur, you free?
Sure, old man.
Enough of that old man nonsense. I'm in the prime of my life.
Oh, I'm sorry. How you getting on?
Bored. You see that swamp, Arthur? That's God's own pantry. What are we eating? Venison? Come on, let's go gather some crawfish. See what else we can get.
Crawfish?
Yeah, crawfish. Finest eating there is. It's not just crawfish.
No. There's monsters out there that'll eat a feller for fun.
Oh, Arthur, I thought you were a man.
No, sir. When it comes to prehistoric monsters, I am very much a coward.
Head for those trees across from us, and we'll take a look. On the starboard side.
What?
My left, your right. This is a boat, Arthur.
Okay. Whatever you say.
Okay, go slow so I can see. My eyes aren't what they used to be. No, no, ground is too high here. Keep following the shoreline.
What exactly are we looking for?
We're looking for low ground and a lot of muck. Pull us in over there.
Here?
Yeah, yeah, come on.
There's more than crawfish in these waters.
Stop your whining, please. It's beneath you. This is the place. Now tell me, Arthur, have you ever birthed a cow?
No.
Right, it's nothing like that, but it's equally as gruesome if you're squeamish.
You're really selling this, aren't you?
Now, do you see this hole?
Yep.
Well, it's sort of like a natural trap. Just want to stick your hand in. Watch. And there! There, you see?
Good. Seems easy enough.
Uh-huh. Let's go find another hole.
So, how long were you in the Navy?
Oh, years. Well, it must have been a year, at least. Or close to that.
That's quite a range.
All water under the bridge now. No pun intended. Oh, look there. Another crayfish hole. You see it? You try this time, Arthur. And remember to reach down deep and get right in there. They like to dig in, the little blighters. It's all right. They don't really bite.
I got something.
Nicely done. Why don't you see if there's any more down there? I bet there's more down there.
There we go.
What did I tell you? Okay, come on. Let's try another hole. Won't be much of a gumbo if we don't find some more. Get down. Get down. Talking of other creatures. There.
Those gators?
Yeah. Three. And they're female. Must be guarding nests.
So?
Gator eggs. Really valuable. Even better eating. I'd love cooking with them.
Okay.
Tell you what. I'm gonna sneak over to the other side of them. Draw their attention. And then run like hell. Now, assuming I don't get eaten, you go plunder the nests.
That's your plan? You're madder than I thought.
Shh. I've done it before in Sumatra. It's easy.
I've heard that line before.
Oh, ye of little faith. Wait here, Mr. Morgan.
Yeah! Yeah! Come on! Excellent. That's what I call teamwork.
I don't think I've ever seen you move that fast.
People pay a lot of money for those eggs. I'm told there's a collector in Saint Denis who gives top dollar for them. For millinery, of all things.
Yeah, because who doesn't want a hat with an egg on it?
Well, this has been very pleasant. Very pleasant indeed. That was fun. I must get out more.
Is that your idea of fun, is it?
Thank you. Here, have some crawfish. I'll give you some of those eggs.
Then maybe you could hatch that, get yourself a new friend.
There's a thought. A new reptilian best buddy. To replace Mike, I suppose.
Yeah. How you doing, Mrs. Adler?
How are you? Been quite a journey since I joined you fellas.
Yes.
And now you and Dutch have joined high society. Oh, Lord above.
Yeah, it seems so.
I think my days in polite society are over.
Well, I just saw Bill Williamson at a party at the San Denise's mayor's house. If he can do it, anyone can.
You get any leads?
Yeah, I think so.
You know so, Arthur Morgan. Come on. We need to talk. Mrs. Adler, will you excuse us?
When are you going to let me come robbing with you, Dutch?
My lord, a few more like her, we could take over the whole world.
A few more like her, there wouldn't be much of a world left.
Yes, perhaps.
Now, the trolley bus station.
I went down there. I took a look at it. I think we can hit it.
I ain't never robbed in a city before.
Yeah, well, you leave the planning to me. You'll ride with me.
Always. Is it just you and me?
No, we'll need one more, I reckon.
I say Lenny.
Not Micah.
Well, that depends if you want a massacre or a payday.
No, I wish that there was something I could do to make the two of you get along better.
Well, that's easy. Make them change.
Very funny.
What is that?
What the hell have they done to me?
Look, there in the tree line.
Everybody take cover! Driscoll boys are coming!
Damn!
Hold it back!
Let's get these windows covered quickly. John, you take the windows over there. Charles, you take the side door there. Arthur, you take the windows in the back. Go!
There! 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 Get them all!
Is everyone accounted for?
I think.
Hey! I said it!
I don't know! I think!
There must be desperate coming here!
That's Mrs. Adler. She's still out there! Cover me.
Okay.
Who's this lady here? Dutch always had a fondness for women.
Hold on! Sadie?
Why didn't you get inside?
And miss all this? Come on, Arthur.
Now we go back.
We need you in the house, Mrs. Adler.
Oh, no, they don't.
Okay?
I think so.
Except for Karen here. Poor kid. Mr. Swanson, would you take this boy and bury him someplace near, but not too near?
Of course. Charles, help me with the body.
We need to get this place cleaned up. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw.
Already taking care of it. Come on now, work.
Colm O'Driscoll. That man can really hate.
So can I, Arthur. So can I. We need to get moving. Away from here.
So we should start looking for another camp.
You ain't thinking big enough, Arthur. You ain't seeing the vastness of our problems and our opportunities.
I'm not sure I get you.
You will, son. You will. Meet me near the trolley station. We got work.
Shall we?
Yep.
He saved my life, and I could not save his. Mrs. Adler fought braver than any of us. She is driven by powerful forces I scarcely understand. That's what love has done to her, I guess.
There you are. Come on. Keep walking. You're late.
couple of days in this place, you turned into some clock-watching city boy. What's the urgency?
We need to leave forever. We've been doing well, making money, but for us all to leave together, we need enough for a boat. Now, I found a friendly ship captain. He's willing to take us to Australia or Tahiti. We just need to pay for passage and give him money for land when we get there. No questions asked. We will disappear, be reborn.
Well, where the hell is Tahiti?
South Pacific, an untouched paradise.
Who lives there?
Tahitians, I guess.
How are we gonna get enough money for the passage of a whole boat, a captain's discretion, and land enough to keep us all?
In there.
So we are gonna rob that place.
Well, I didn't think we was fixing the plumbing. I don't know if you have noticed, but we are on the clock. I reckon we got a few days before the Pinkerton show, and then, well, we're done. Now, we need money. Bronte said this place has got money. Come on!
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a robbery. Behave as I tell you, and none of you will die. Annoy me, and you all will. Now remember, we just
Help
want
me.
Money. Don't make us kill you.
Hand over all
Mr.
your money M. now.
Leave these fine Quick. Folks or their valuables. Mr. S, check that room
But Jesus.
Back there. I got this one dying. That's your choice, not mine. Kindly open that gate and let my acquaintance inside.
Give me your money.
I
ain't
said,
worth dying.
Open the gate right. and let Is my acquaintance okay? in. Yes, of course.
Come on. These folks must
okay.
have something on.
Give me everything you got. Quick.
Okay. Fine, it's yours. There's nothing much here.
What?
There's nothing really here.
You're sure?
Yes.
Then get out here and get ready for company. All of you! Behave. We don't want to hurt any of you. Mr. M, check the safe.
Sure. Open it.
I don't think they keep much cash in there.
Open it! There's almost nothing here.
There should be stacks of cash in there. He told us there was. Look again.
There's no stacks. A few dollars in coins. That's it. Damn!
We got a problem. There's a ton of cops out there.
Come out now! We got you surrounded!
That greasy son of a bitch! He set us up!
You think?
This seemed like a good time for sarcasm to you, Arthur.
What are we gonna do, gentlemen?
Something! The trolley. The trolley! Follow me, gentlemen!
Go now! Does this trolley go to Tahiti?
I hope so. All right, shoot us some space, boys. Look out on the right.
Get that bastard!
What's those side alleys on?
We got some on the balcony, too.
That bastard must have called in every cop in the city.
Some riders coming on this side.
Arthur, cover our left, plenty. Arthur, you need to help Lenny now. Arthur, coming out of the bank on the right. Bronte is gonna pay for this.
You'll regret getting out of the road, old man, and you will stop.
Outside the saloon. Oh, damn. We are really moving here. Arthur, slow it. Slow this thing down.
I'll try.
Just keep shooting till nothing moves.
This is our chance to move. Let's go.
Get out of here, Arthur! You okay, Dutch?
Took a real bang on the head back there. I'm seeing three of everything.
You stay down, and I'll hold them off.
They're chasing us. Take them out!
Look! We ain't done yet!
Out of here.
I think we're clear.
You know what, Dutch? Next time, let's not damn discretion.
Seemed like a good lead.
I know, but...
Well, we made it. Thanks to you.
Don't mention it.
Yeah.
You're a good kid.
And we each got $15. Oh, and a quarter. Don't forget the quarter.
Shut up, Arthur. He set us up. Played me like a yokel. Put the law on us. What did we do to him? What did I do to him?
I guess he thinks he's the king around here. He don't want the likes of you. So, what are we doing next, Dutch?
We just need money. One more decent take, and we're gone. The bank is our bet. Hosea agrees.
Even after that?
Especially after that. I don't feel so good.
Now you just got a bash on the head.
Come on. I'm taking you back to camp.
Hey, you did real good there, Lenny. Just wish it could have turned out better.
Well, can't win them all.
Ah, there you are, dear boy.
Yes, here I am.
Well, we're going to need to get you smartened up a bit.
Why?
Well, you can't play at the tables on a Lanahassee riverboat looking like this.
You can't?
Not if you want to fit in so well that no one will realize you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
Are we still doing that?
Of course. We're going to fix you up so fine no one will notice a thing.
Hello, can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes, my friend here is in need of a new suit. We are playing on the riverboat this evening.
Make this gentleman look like the Duke he really is. It was the English's fault his grandfather had to emigrate. A bitter and jealous people. You can see the aristocrat in his profile. The heavy brow from all the inbreeding.
Might I suggest the fine three-piece town suit, sir? Perfect for the occasion, I'd say.
A very good choice, sir.
Come on, let's get you to the barber.
Sure.
Good luck tonight, gentlemen.
Herr Strauss has scoped the whole thing out. It's quite ingenious, actually.
What is?
The action he has planned. Indeed, it's not much of an action at all. You play cards and win. And you're going to bet very big and flamboyantly while you win. And everyone's going to think you're some new money from the oil fields come to lay it on thick and drunk. All the while, Herr Strauss will be signaling you in your line of sight. When you bust the place, they'll take you upstairs to pay you off. And that is when Javier comes in, and you take whatever you want.
You don't think they might see an armed Mexican coming into the safe with me?
Sure, they might, but perhaps not. You will see.
The suspense is killing me.
Oh, don't be so jaded. We both know this is just the kind of innocent fun you thrive on.
Well, after the past couple of months, armed robbery don't seem such an innocent pastime.
No, but we, you, all of us, will be done here soon.
I hope so.
Come on.
My good man, could you smarten up my dear hick friend here? This unlikely fellow has made himself a fortune in the oil fields. and learned himself not a lick of manners or gentlemanly deportment.
Well, very good, sir.
No, it's not good. Not good at all. Not if they're going to let him play big at the tables tonight. Make him look like a prince, sir.
There, very smart.
Come on, let's get to the docks.
I've arranged some transportation for us.
To the Grand Corrigan, please.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you. From Toad to Prince.
This is a bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't whinny up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to burn. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. This ain't happening. So, who's the mark?
Are you all right, by the way, the driver?
Oh, yes, don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery, of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't. But the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right cards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
And what money am I playing with?
Don't worry. That has all been arranged. Your chips will be waiting for you.
You know, people keep complaining about the smallest thing.
There she is. Come on.
Okay.
Arthur, leave any weaponry here. They'll search us when we get on. George, we'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir.
Now remember what I said, Arthur. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Yes, yes, believe me, I heard every word.
Watch Strauss, listen to the dealer, and this should be a very lucky night. There they are. Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you. Arthur, you remember this pair of boys we met in New York? Come on. Champagne is on dear old Arthur. He's rich as can be and feeling luckier than a turkey that survived Thanksgiving.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, dear boy.
Morning, James.
Come on, let's head aboard. Drinks on Arthur. Champagne.
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time, but don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Now where can I get a cocktail?
Are you joining us?
Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Desmond Blythe.
Evening.
Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen,
Let's play.
Hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all faring?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have. Okay, sorry, boys, I'm taking it all.
We'll see about that.
To hell with it.
Well, hello, my ladies.
Down to the belt.
Damn it!
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So, what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny. I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting into hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife. I'll, raise.
I'll call. Sorry to do this to you, but I have no choice. All in.
Now what the hell? It's only money. Interesting. Pair of cowgirls. Shit! Shit! I guess my luck held. Is that you done?
Done?
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
Well, I heard there was some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation of his up in New Hanover.
Let's not waste any more time here. All in.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Pair of kings.
Very good, but not good enough.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you!
No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen.
Please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure. Perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Come with me, sir. You're having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Next, we'll be hiring Negroes.
I know.
I think you're going to like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made, but you can't have everything.
Indeed.
Well, here we are. Just give me 1 second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur.
I guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Idiot, huh?
Shit, let's hope no one heard that. Quick, clear the safe. Let's get out of here. Can't believe that asshole had another gun.
The view in here is looking pretty good.
How much is there?
Must be a few thousand, plus the watch.
Nice. Now let's get out of here. Come on. Let's go meet the others.
Sure.
I reckon we've only got a few minutes to get out of here.
If we're lucky.
Was that a gunshot?
It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Oh, garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. I give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away until we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
At the time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
It's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
Friend is not a no good chief, and I beg you to take back the insinuation.
There he is.
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is. Shoot that man.
Never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch.
Apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss, a Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here.
Things good with you?
Hello?
Excuse me. You believe this? Went to the shop looking for a new
Do I know you?
Mr. I believe we've met.
We have?
At that ghastly party.
Oh, Evelyn Miller.
Unfortunately so, Mr.
Arthur Morgan, at least sometimes.
Can I say something rude?
Sure.
The mayor thinks you robbed him. To be clear, he wasn't very upset about it. He rather liked you.
Okay.
Do you, can you steal things?
Is there a reason you're asking me to incriminate myself, Mr. Miller?
Well, I'm sorry. Have you met? This is Rainsfall, a great chief, and his son, Eagle Flies.
Gentlemen, we saw you in the wagon train crossing the river at Cumberland Falls. And at the party, you were upstairs.
You have great powers of observation.
Yes, my people, if we are even a people anymore. We've fought hard. We've made peace treaties, and those treaties were broken, and we've been moved and punished and moved.
I'm sure.
And now I am told we are to be moved again.
Clearly contravening the peace treaty signed 3 years ago.
This will lead to war.
No, my son, it will not. We cannot fight another war. They have got stronger, and we have become far weaker, Mr. Morgan.
It's a bad business.
It's to do with oil. I know it is, but I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So, you want me to try and steal it?
Obviously, they can't. And even more obviously, I would be useless. Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament, but I'm a working man. I got problems of my own.
We will pay you very handsomely, Mr. Morgan.
How much?
I told you, they're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in two states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you. Like you, I've been running for as long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is nigh undone.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, that appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And his. Oh.
We must try everything. Come along.
Hello, Mr. Miller. The counselor wants to apologize. He can see you now.
We've been waiting I don't know how long.
Or next month, if you'd like to reschedule.
Come. Perhaps the senator won't mind waiting.
Yeah.
You came.
Of course I came. Said I would.
There's a foreman.
His name is Danbury. Is the files in the office above the refinery room. It's that window with the blind drawn up.
I see it.
If the files are as incriminating as we believe, Mr. Cornwall's men will destroy them if they know you're coming.
There's only one of me, son. I don't intend for them to know I'm coming. What will the files say?
There'll be a report from Leyland Oil Development Company.
And you got the money?
Yes.
Any ideas how I sneak into this place?
You could crawl under the fence or hide in a wagon. They keep rolling in.
I'll go take a look.
If there's a problem, call for me.
I thought the whole point was that this had nothing to do with you.
Ideally. If you are quick, you could climb into the back of that wagon. Otherwise, you'll have to sneak past the guards.
You, Al?
Hey, Tom?
Picking up?
Yep. Supposed to meet the early train to Saint Denis.
Okay. Better get a move on then.
Start loading up.
Must be Danbury.
Who?
What? Quieten yourself, friend. This won't take long. Danbury.
Yes?
I need some papers, my friend. Nothing important. A file. I'm from head office.
You're not from head office?
Does that seem important right now?
No.
I need a file by the Leyland Oil Development Company. The one about the oil near Wapiti?
I...
Danbury, think, man. A mind is a terrible thing to lose, especially over such a nice floor as this.
Thank you.
Nateer! Nateer!
You done good, Danbury. Real good. They'll give you a promotion for this. Nope. Danbury.
Danbury? Danbury, you okay?
Tell the guard you're fine.
Yes. All's fine.
Now stay quiet. Our head office will send me back to get you.
Weapons on the ground and hands in the air.
Easy now, fellas.
Now, we won't tell you again.
Coming after us!
I was happy to watch some of that oil burn. So you met Mr. Danbury?
Yes, don't worry. He was very obliging. I thought you wasn't getting involved.
Thought you were gonna enter and leave silently.
Thank you. You saved my life.
Thank you. I hope. Well, I don't know what I hope. But who knows? Maybe these will be of some use. Here's your money.
Thank you.
So, Arthur, you get the deciding vote.
About what?
We take an insult and scurry off like cockroaches? Or deal with business the right way?
We don't need to take revenge. We hardly know the guy.
This ain't about revenge, Hosea. Angelo Bronte don't mean shit to me. This is about the fact we are planning to rob a bank in his town. A bank that he no doubt protects. A town where his men are gunning for us. Before we do that, we need to put him out of commission.
I disagree. There's always an easier way.
There ain't no easier way. Now, I know his type. He is a vindictive little power broker who rules by fear. Now, we pull that stunt in his cesspit of a town, we're doomed. You want to leave this place? leave this country? We need that money.
It just don't feel good, Dutch.
This is it. This is the last job that we are ever going to pull. Before the year is out, we are going to be harvesting mangoes in Tahiti. Farmers. But we need seed capital, and we need to leave. You know it. I know it.
Forgive me if I can't think too much about the mango harvest.
This is it. Trust me. Arthur.
If it's business, well, business is business.
Angelo Bronte stands between us and our future.
You'll damn us all.
Arthur, come on.
You better be right about this one.
I am.
I've heard that before, and usually I've been right.
If you say so.
Quit doubting, Arthur. It does no favors. Come on. We need to go see a man about a boat.
A boat?
We're headed to a settlement called Le Gras. I met a boatman there called Thomas who knows these waters like the back of his hand.
Why do we need a boat?
So we can attack Bronte's mansion from the swamp. Catch him off guard. He knows we survived the trolley station, so he'll be expecting some kind of reprisal.
All right. Okay, makes sense.
See? I do still possess some capacity for rational thought, Arthur. Okay, follow me. Thank you.
For what?
For taking my side back there.
It ain't about sides.
Feels like Hosea's lost his spine.
This move on Bronte, is it for the bank job or revenge for what happened at the trolley station?
Both. Neither. What does it matter? We need to hit that bank. And Bronte has the police and just about everything else in Saint-Denis in his back pocket. He also set us up, and lest we forget, took young Jack.
I understand. We just got a lot of pots on the boil, given all the folks who's out gunning for us.
You all seem to have forgotten how money is made and what it takes to support 20 people, let alone what it takes to give 20 people a new life overseas.
With all due respect, Dutch, is this Tahiti plan really gonna work out?
You tell me, Arthur. Is it? Have some goddamn faith. I am bending over backwards to make a future for us.
I know, but...
But, when did you become so small-minded? If you'd rather we break up the family, go our separate ways, just tell me.
Of course not.
This isn't a prison camp. I am not forcing anybody to stay. So either we're in this together, working together to get out together, or we're not. There simply isn't a reality in which we do nothing and get everything.
I know. You're right. Just feels like we're on borrowed time again. I mean, the O'Driscolls found us.
Yeah, we need to move. And soon. Haven't I made that clear? I feel like I'm going in circles with all of you. Micah is the only one left with any loyalty. Anyway, here we are. Let me do the talking. Thomas, it is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Mr. Dutch.
Thomas, have you met Arthur? Arthur, Thomas is quite the boatman. He's going to help us get close to our prey. The other night we had quite the adventure fishing for catfish. Now, my friend, can I call in that favor?
What do you need?
You know Angelo Bronte. Well, exactly. We need to make a social call. We were hoping you could row us in quietly one evening around the back of his house.
Well, if anyone can, I can.
We'll pay you for your trouble.
Could If you bringing him trouble, it won't be no trouble for me.
Good.
My business partner, Jules, he's out on the skiff. I need to check with him. Plus, I need to check the traps. Would you come with me?
Of course. Arthur?
Why not?
Shouldn't take too long if we can find him.
Be lively. Mind you, there's a lot of gators. Uncommon number. Big ones.
Great.
Come now, Arthur. It'll take more than a prehistoric reptile to scare you, Shirley.
I just want to see you meet your match when it comes to an aging predator with a big mouth, Dutch.
Arthur here is something of a comedian, Thomas. More of a jester than a gunslinger.
Well, if you say so, Mr. Dutch. This way. Come on, this way. Follow me here. And stay on the higher ground.
You call this ground? It feels like water to me.
Down here, we can't be too picky there, Mr. Arthur.
Got a couple of crayfish traps up ahead.
Mr. Dutch, you keep a lookout for company. Mr. Arthur, check the traps with me. Can you please check the other one for me, Mr. Arthur?
This one's empty.
All right. I got a few more set over this way. Come on.
I don't want to know what just touched my leg.
Mr. Dutch, you show you the right fellas to be going after Angelo Brunton?
Oh, he's much more the kind of reptile I can handle.
Now stay close. Make sure you follow my line.
Oh, I fully intend to, Thomas.
You too, Mr. Arthur.
You can see why evening swamp wading hasn't caught on as a pastime, can't you?
I love it out here. Peaceful. Nobody bothering you none. Except for the night folk sometimes.
The night folk?
Yep, some strange people around these parts. Wilder than the animals they are.
Well, this just gets better and better.
Whoa. Stop where you are. That's a gator. Just stay as still as you can. Let's keep moving. I got another trap by that small island up here. I don't know what's taking Jules so long with that boat.
I think we are all equally keen to find her.
A hand here, Mr. Arthur. This trap is stuck in the mud. It happens.
Ooh. Guess something didn't want to be caught.
My gosh. So it's true.
What is?
There's been talk of a big old bull. But people talk a lot of nonsense. I guess this was... No, but only something huge could do this.
Oh. Fantastic. Let's hope it bites you first, Dutch.
Should we just keep moving? I don't really want to hang around here much longer.
All right. I suppose this can wait. Let's go. Hold up.
My God, there's no shortage of them.
Good eating.
Us or them?
Exactly. Come on. We really should have run into Jules by now. I reckon we should split up so we can search both sides.
Okay, Arthur, since you appear so at home here, you take the right. We'll go left.
What?
Just keep your eyes open.
Someone there? Jules?
Here! Help!
That must be him.
Hey, you in the tree. What are you doing?
There's a monster. A monster.
You okay up there?
There's a monster.
Where?
Mastiff, it nearly ate me.
Where'd he go?
It's out there.
What?
A big gator. Biggest I ever saw. Big and nasty. Knocked me off the boat and chased me over here.
You must be Jules.
Yes.
Where is the boat?
Over there. I ran.
Okay. Yeah. And where'd this monster swim off to?
I think that way.
I got the skiff. It's over here. Stuck. I got it loose. Go.
Good man.
All right, let's get back to the dock.
Yes, please, let's go.
Thank God. So, who are these fellas, Thomas?
Two new friends of mine. I'll explain later.
Jules, we are very happy to have finally made your acquaintance.
I thought I was gonna be out here all night.
What was you doing hiding up in the tree, boy?
This gator was huge, Thomas. Twice as big as I ever seen. Twice as angry, too.
Nonsense.
Now what?
I think we hit a tree stump.
Yeah, I thought we cleared. You're gonna need to jump in and pull us free.
Me?
Yeah, just do it. Won't take you a minute, boy. Go on.
This is a bad idea.
You'll see any giant monster long before it gets anywhere near you. Got a couple of crack gunslingers here, but the gun's loaded. You'll be fine.
You didn't see the thing.
Yeah, neither did you. It's just a myth, Jules. Now pull. Come on, put your back into it.
Jules?
Shit.
He won't kin.
No, I'm going in.
No, no, we can't lose the boat. Arthur will go.
I will?
Quick. Hurry, Arthur.
Come here, son!
Help!
something!
Hurry up, Arthur! Don't look behind you! Keep going!
God, oh God, no! Please hurry! My leg!
Fire off a couple of warning shots just to pretend you care!
No. Please hurry!
I got you covered! Come on! Hurry! Hurry!
Give me the boy! Put him here! Come on! Get him here!
Miss Arthur! Come on!
Come on! Come,
come
on! Quickly! Quickly!
Here, this leg hurts pretty bad. He should be okay.
Get in!
Keep shooting!
Finish that son of a bitch, Arthur!
You're gonna be all right, George. Just hold on. It's coming right for us.
He's going.
Shit, that is one big old gate.
Oh, your boy doesn't look too good there.
Here, take this. Try to stop the bleeding.
You're gonna be okay, son. You're gonna be okay. Just thank your old Uncle Dutch.
I heard that. There's still a lot of blood. You need to put pressure on it.
I've stopped the bleeding. I think he'll be okay if he don't get a fever.
We can bring down a fever.
A fever is the least of our worries. Look who's back.
God damn it.
Put every bullet you've got in him. Dead ahead of us. You see him? Shoot! Okay, I think it's had enough.
Now, Jesus, can we get back now? You're gonna be okay, kid.
Sorry, Jules. Guess all them stories was true. Big and bad. That's unusual. Normally, the little one's angry. Big ones is lazy.
Well, I guess he never outgrew his anger. Kind of reminds me of you, Arthur.
You know, I don't think I've ever seen you squeal before, Dutch.
I weren't the one squealing.
Yeah, well, you weren't in the water with him. And this poor boy was nearly dinner.
Can we get some help? Jules has been bitten.
Oh, my God.
There's a monster out here. He's been bitten, but he's alive. Just keep him warm. Feed him garlic for the infection. Thank you. Both of you. I'm at your service anytime you need.
Thank you, Thomas. Where can we find you?
You just meet me back here.
Very good.
Can one of you help me put the boat back out?
Sure. I'm gonna head back to camp and placate the irritable Miss O'Shea, who's causing more trouble. I'll collect the boys. Meet you back here, Arthur.
Mr. Arthur? Old Bronte. He's a bad man.
I know.
Killed some good folks. Hurt a lot of people.
Well, he definitely lacks a certain charm. I'll see you soon.
You be safe. We got monsters out here.
Well.
So, Dutch, what's Tahiti like anyhow?
I have no idea, but I hear it's paradise. Arthur, there you are. Come on. Thomas. Let's get going.
Right you are.
Hey, Bill, you were a sharpshooter in the cavalry, weren't you?
What?
When we get there, maybe you could help with the suppression fire.
I never said I was no sharpshooter.
Oh, that's right. What was it? The nation's most loyal latrine digger, wasn't that it?
Yeah, well, I fought, and I fought well.
So you always tell us.
You taught me something you could do with learning. Them Indians were savages.
Watch them out there, boy. Watch it. Only type of savage in these parts are moonshine, swilling, pompous, inbred locals.
Dutch, I saw things out there.
I don't doubt you saw things, Bill, but your tiny little mind was too small to comprehend what you saw. What you saw was people who lost everything to savagery. Savagery of peasants. Failures come from Europe to reap some awful vengeance on God's last creation.
Interesting way you boys got to prepare for a killing.
I'm sorry I wasted my life trying to teach you boys.
Love you, though, I do.
Well, leaving love aside, you think we got this?
Don't you never leave love aside, Arthur. It's all we got. Pick us up yonder.
I got you.
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
Come on, quick. Stay quiet. Lenny, Bill, you're with me. Arthur, John, you take the left side. If you see a shot, you take it. Okay? Good luck, gentlemen. Arthur, let's go.
Let's go.
You see those two? Stay out of sight. Got a shot on him?
Something could...
Shoot that lock, Arthur. Good. Now kick that damn door in. Arthur,
look out!
That's even better. Shoot.
Voilà.
door covered.
Bronte must be up there. Let's go.
God damn it!
I'm sorry, friend. No, name your price. Name your price. Every man have a price. Eh? Okay, okay. No, I surrender. I surrender.
Should we kill him?
Nah, let's take him to Dutch.
You can carry him. I ain't touching that piece of shit.
Chat, Mr. Bronte.
Let's go! Come on! Put your guns down!
That's on the beach,
come on, Morgan! We're getting the hell out of here!
Arthur! Get a move on!
How's in the name of the law?
Put him in the front. Bill, you help.
You got him?
Oh, come on, Lenny.
All right, come on. Let's get out of here.
Yep.
Oh, hey, big man. We gonna ransom you or what?
You're pathetic.
Oh, I am. Because from where I'm sitting, you're the one deserving of pity, my friend. All your men, all your money, it weren't no match for a bunch of bumpkins.
You are nothing. You do nothing. You mean nothing. You stand for nothing. Me, I run a city. And when the law catch up to you, you will die like nothing. I am this country. You are what people are running from.
I possess things that you will never understand.
You don't even possess your own men. $1,000 to the man who kills him and sets me free.
What are you gonna say now?
They are even bigger fools than you.
No doubt.
The law will find you. Already, the dogs are on the way.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you're right. You are so right.
They are good at smelling filth, huh? So filth has got to be this our friends, the Pinkertons, gonna come and rescue you, you repulsive little maggot! Oh, God!
The goddamn alligator, Dutch.
The part that covers weakness. That part. I don't know.
Well, I do. It ain't nice. I know it. But it is us or him.
I figure it might as well be him.